Hey, Richard, how you doing? Sorry you couldn't make it here today, but we're having a good time, and see you sometime down the road.
Cool. There we go. We're ready to go.
Hey, Richard, how's it going? This is Johnny Whitaker from Family Affair. Signing in the Sea Monster. Sorry that you missed us. Hope to see you next time. Happy Thanksgiving.
Thanks a lot. You're just too kind.
Hi, Richard. It's so nice to see you. Thanks for stopping by.
Is it on?
It's on, yeah.
Hi, Richard. Where are you? Why aren't you here? And which one of my movies do you like the best? And you have to go see The Outfitters. Get a tape of that.
I'll go hit Blockbuster for that one.
There's the fan club, so you can write to me and let me, you know, tell me hello.
What I need. A friend of mine couldn't make it. I was wondering if I could videotape you. No, you won't do it? No? It's whatever you want.
Hello, Richard. I guess you couldn't come, but I'm sorry. I wish I could have seen you. It was nice to meet you even through the little lens that you gave me. Which you don't look like very much from here. Bye.
Richard the King, Rishwain.
Yeah.
Hello, Richard the King, Rishwain. This is Carol Lindley at the Hollywood Autograph Show here in San Francisco. We're missing you terribly, Richard. Come back. Come visit.
You know, in Kara, Shelley and Pierce, and
hey, Richard, I understand you're the king. Sorry you're not here, that I could talk to you in person, but have a good day.
Thanks.
Hey, Richard the King, you're not here, what's the deal? I'm actually trying to leave. Your buddy shows up with my case packed. I'm ready to go, but I opened it up just for him. You should be here. Next year, come.
All right.
Hi, Richard. Hello from another Richard. Nice talking to you.
The King Rishwain.
Oh, King Rishwain. This is Don Stroud. I'd like to say hello, and I wish you were here. We miss you, my friend. Good luck to you.
Hey, is it true that you went out with...
Did you want to take a photo
with Jim Dandy?
I was just asked for $5 and it's a donation to animal charity.
The show was like everybody else.
So you never dated him?
No.
Did you even meet the guy?
Yes.
What's he like?
Nice. But I was friendly with, the guitar player was my, like a really dear friend of mine. And yeah, it was just
blown out of proportion.
Fairly new to my poor fellow.
Poor fellow?
Well, I mean, he was, you know, claimed that he was dating me and I was, you know, 16. And
he claimed?
No.
Oh.
People claim. Oh, okay. Never mind. Well, I'm done with this.
I
okay.
Got you. So you knew Jack Webb, I guess.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
How was it?
Oh, Jack was great.
Was it really?
Yeah, honestly. Did you ever see the D.I.?
Oh, yeah, of course. One of my favorite movies.
What you see is what you get.
Yeah? No, he wasn't that bad, was he?
Well, I wouldn't call him bad. I thought he was great. I got along with him. But he was like that. I mean, that's why he had all these successful shows and things went good and he got things done.
Yeah, I've heard he's a cheap son of a bitch. That's what I've heard. I'm just saying.
What?
I heard he was a cheap son of a bitch.
Cheap?
Yeah, that's what I heard. I swear.
How could he be cheap?
Jack Webb then.
I did.
You did?
I used to go to a place called the Cock and Bull on Sunset Street. We used to drink and come in at lunch.
You and Jack Webb?
Yeah.
What was he like? Everyone says he's a cheap son of a bitch. That's what I always hear.
Whatever.
Whatever.
So was Frank Sinatra.
Yeah.
There you go.
But was he a good guy?
Great guy.
Yeah?
Jack Lloyd. A lot of people don't like Jack Lloyd. Our best friends got rid of his soul.
He's such an amazing man. That's what I heard. I heard he was a great guy.
Well, a lot of people, he had a lot of trouble with a lot of people, but didn't bother me.
Huh?
You ever seen the Hawaii Five-O?
No, I didn't know you were in Hawaii Five-O.
Four times. Great parts. That was a fun show.
Yeah?
Okay. Go to Hawaii, the little penthouse and all that.
Webb like? What was Jack Webb like?
Oh, he was really great. Actually not too different from the detective in Dragnet. You know, very dry. Actually saved my career because I've had a lot lot of negative publicity. They were trying to get me out of my spot where I was in with somebody else. And the studio would not have anything to do with me, and they asked me to do this film. And I went to the interview. I said, "You're sure you don't want to? Sure you want to hire me? I'm supposed to be such a horrible person." He said, "Do you want to do the film?" I said, "Yes." He said, "You're in." And 2 weeks later, both of them took a car. They went to my studio and involved everybody out. And they said, "If you don't make that girl work, you are out of your mind." And that started my career.
Really?
No, listen, Jack was dynamite. I've got great Jack Webb stories. I had a lot of fun with him. A very quick one. I don't know if you know my background. I did westerns, a lot of my Laramie and Wagon Train and western movies and whatever. And I wasn't interested in 1970 in doing a medical show. And my agent called me and said, "Jack Webb has got a new series and he's interested in you doing the lead in it." And I said, "What's it called?" I didn't know Jack Webb, never met the man. And my agent said, "It's called Emergency." And I said, "Emergency? That sounds like a medical thing." And my agent said, "Yeah, it is." And I said, "No, I'm not interested. I'm waiting for a Western to come along." And at that time, there were no Westerns coming along, and there haven't been since. And my agent said, "You don't understand. This is not an interview. He thinks that you're the only actor in Hollywood to play Dr. Brackett, and he wants to see you after hours tonight in his office." And I said, "Well, what the hell? I owe the man that courtesy to go in and tell him to his face that I don't want to do his series." So I said, "All right." I put my suit and tie on that evening at 8 o'clock. I went over to Universal and went into his office. And his secretary, Jean, said, "Oh, just a minute. They're in a big meeting. They're all waiting for you." And a couple minutes later, they told me to go in. I walked in, and there were some of the big execs from the studio there. Lou Wasserman and a few of the people, and Jack, they were all sitting around having cocktails. And I knew the other people, but I didn't know Jack. And he said, "Oh, come in, Bob. You know, how are you? I'm Jack Webb." And I said, "Hi, Mr. Webb. It's a pleasure to meet you." And they said, "But right now I have to tell you that I am not interested in doing a medical series." And he looked at me like this and said, "Shut up and sit down." He said, "Do you drink?" And I said, "Yeah." He said, "Go fix yourself a drink and sit down." I went over, fixed myself a drink. I sat down in front of his desk. 2 hours later, I walked out of that office with 13 pages of a two-hour world premiere television series with 13 episodes sold to go to work in 10 days.